Hello dear students, welcome to the class. So today I'm going to teach you about Napoleon Bonaparte through this PPT presentation. So in the previous class I taught you about the French Revolution, its causes, then the outbreak and the storming of Bastille. Then I even discussed about the results of the French Revolution. So today I'm going to teach you about Napoleon Bonaparte through this PowerPoint presentation. So let's start with it. So Napoleon Bonaparte, also known as Napoleon I, was a French military leader and the emperor who conquered much of Europe in the early 19th century. Born on the island of Corsica, Napoleon rapidly rose through the ranks of military during the French Revolution. After seizing political power in France in 1799, that is Coupe d'Etat, he crowned himself emperor in 1804. So what is the meaning of Coupe d'Etat? Coupe d'Etat means forcing the government to fight against you. Okay, that is known as Coupe d'Etat. So let's start. So this is the picture of Napoleon Bonaparte. I took it from the internet. So the copyright is with someone who has already uploaded this in the web. So now let's start. So early life. Napoleon Bonaparte was born on August 15, 1769 in Jessico on the Mediterranean island of Corsica. He was the second of eight surviving children born to Carlo Bonaparte. Carlo Bonaparte was the father of Napoleon Bonaparte. He was a lawyer and Letizia Romalina Bonaparte. The mother name was Letizia Romalina Bonaparte. Okay, so mother died in 1836 and father died in 1785. Okay, the next one. As a boy, Napoleon attended a school in mainland France where he learned the French language and went to graduate from French Military Academy in 1785. He then became a second lieutenant in an artillery regiment of French army from the very beginning. So he studied in a military school and then you can see that he became a second lieutenant in the artillery regiment of the French army. So from 1803 to 1815, France, as you know, that engaged in the Napoleonic War, a series of major conflicts with various coalitions of European nations. Many of the European nations were against Napoleon. So 1803, partly as a means to raise funds for future war. In order to raise funds for the future war, Napoleon sold France Louisiana territory in North America to newly independent United States. So this territory was sold to United States in order to raise the funds for the Napoleonic War. So in future wars will be inevitable, so funds were required. So he sold the France Louisiana territory in North America. So Louisiana territory was in North America. It was sold to newly independent United States. Okay. In 1810, Russia withdrew from the continental system. So that is something different. Continental system, everywhere blockades were there imposed by Napoleon. So in retaliation, Napoleon led a massive army into Russia. So Napoleon was very much annoyed. That is why he led a massive army into Russia in summer 1812. So in 1812, Napoleon led the army to enter into Russia. Okay, so Napoleon's forces marched onto Moscow. Moscow is the capital of Russia. So in order to discover, almost the entire population evacuated. So when he reached over there, so what he discovered, the almost the entire population was evacuated. So before Napoleon reached to Russia, the entire population of Moscow was evacuated. No one was there. So when the Russian's army retreated, so the retreating Russian army set fires across the city. They themselves set fire across the city in order to, or we can say that, an effort to deprive enemy troops of supplies. So they wanted to cut off the supply troops of the enemies. So they themselves, retreating means moving back. You are moving back into your territory, setting fires across the city in an effort to deprive enemy troops to or any sort of supplies. Okay, that was done. So in 1813, by the Battle of Leipzig, you must remember the name Battle of Leipzig, known as Battle of Nations also, in which Napoleon's forces were defeated. in the Battle of Leipzig, which was held in the year 1813, the Napoleon's forces were defeated by a coalition. Coalition means number of countries coming together. Okay, they made an alliance and they fought against Napoleon. So the coalition forces, including Austria, Prussia, Russia. That means Austrian, Prussian, Russian, Swedish. That means Austria, Prussia, Russia, and Sweden. They made an alliance to fight against Napoleon. Okay, so in which Napoleon then retreated to France. So Napoleon now had to retreat back, means move back to France. And in March 1814, coalition forces captured Paris. Paris, the capital of France, was completely captured by the coalition forces. Okay, we can say that he was defeated over here. So on April 6, 1814, Napoleon, what did he do? Napoleon then in the mid-40s was forced to abdicate the throne. In the mid-40s, okay, Napoleon was forced to abdicate, means he himself had to leave the throne. The situation was made in such a way that Napoleon himself had to give up the rule. So with the Treaty of Fontainebleau, he was exiled to Elba. So he was exiled to Elba. Elba means, exile means to keep himself far away from the mainland of France. So he was exiled to Elba. So Elba was a Mediterranean island of the coast of Italy. On the coast of Italy, that is on the island of Mediterranean island of coast of Italy, he was exiled. Okay, you can say Banwas. And he was given sovereignty over a small island. Such a ruler, Napoleon, who was a ruler now, he was now been exiled to Elba, and he was given a right to rule over a small island while his wife and son went to Austria. His wife and son went to Austria and he was exiled to Elba. Okay, and he was allowed to look after that territory. Okay, sovereignty means power to rule. Sovereign rule was given to Napoleon. Now next one, on February 26, 1815, after less than a year in exile, when he was in exile, Napoleon managed to escape from Elba, okay, and sail to French mainland with a group of more than 1,000 supporters. His 1,000 supporters were also there. With his support, he reached to the mainland of France. So on March 28th, he returned to Paris. On March 28th, he returned to Paris, where he was welcomed by a cheering crowd. Lots and lots of people, okay, they cheered him and welcomed him. The new king at that time, who was the king? The new king, Louis XVIII, fled. When he heard about the coming of Napoleon, he fled away. And Napoleon began what came to be known as 100 Days Campaign. So from that time onward, a new campaign was started, which came to be known as 100 Days Campaign. So once again, the new king Louis XVIII fled away, and Napoleon began what came to be known as 100 Days Campaign. So he came back to power once again, and he started his 100 Days Campaign. Next one, in June 1815, his forces now invaded Belgium. After coming back from Elba, he managed his forces and then he invaded Belgium. Okay, invaded means forcefully enter Belgium, where British and Prussian troops were stationed. In Belgium, British forces and Prussian forces were already stationed over there. Okay, so on June 16, Napoleon's troops defeated the Prussians in the Battle of Ligny. That means Napoleon's troops defeated Prussians at the Battle of Ligny. However, 2 days later, on June 18, at the Battle of Waterloo, near Brussels, the French was crushed by the British with the assistance from Prussians. So British, with the help of Prussians, managed to defeat Napoleon. So he was completely defeated here over in the year 1815. So in October 1815, Napoleon was exiled to remote British held island of St. Helena in the South Atlantic Ocean. He died there on May 5th, 1829. He died at the age of 51. Most likely from stomach cancer, he died at the age of 51. So he died in the year 1821. So from 1815 onward, he was exiled on the island of St. Helena, that is in South Atlantic Ocean, where he died at the age of 51 in the year 1821, most likely due to cancer. So this is all about Napoleon, a very short chapter. It is just a part of your syllabus I taught you over here. Okay, so thank you for watching it. So in the next class, I'll come with a new topic. So till then, please watch this video again and again for your general information. Okay, so thank you very much. Thank you very much once again. Stay safe, take care, and bye-bye.